our morning rounds, men and their bones, osteoporosis is often considered a woman's problem. Yet one in four men over the age of 50 will break a bone because of this disease.
A new study finds men are three times less likely than women to have a scan after a wrist fracture. They're also seven times less likely to begin treatment for the condition. Our Dr. David Akers is here. Good morning.
Good morning, Charlie.
So what does the new study tell us?
Well, the new study says that when people present to an emergency room with a broken wrist, it's normally a calling card. Hey, you got to check their bone density because they could break others. Well, women proceeded many times to bone density studies, but men didn't, and the men weren't treated. So it really is a wake-up call that doctors, when they're seeing patients with broken bones, need to start screening men for osteoporosis.
But why hadn't they been doing so?
Yeah.
Well, in women, there's a cliff, right? Menopause happens and bone density falls down. And so we know there's a moment in time you got to start screening. With men, it's a continuum, and there hasn't been a study showing when men should start screening. And so the lack of a study means people just aren't doing it.
But do you think men are reluctant? Do you think they're embarrassed? Do you think they're afraid? Or is it just men don't like doctors?
I think it's, well, I think it's all of them. And it's, I mean, some men like me and talk to me. But I think it's all of them. But it's also the fact that they don't aware of it. I mean, when you say osteoporosis, it's a woman's disease.
Right.
Well, it's a responsibility of the medical community.
Yeah, we failed. I mean, one in four men having a major fracture, and you know, you get a hip fracture, that's going to affect the quality of your life for then on out.
So what about the role of vitamin D and calcium? Are those areas where men are also deficient in those vitamins?
Well, it's very interesting. There has yet to be a study showing that taking calcium and vitamin D themselves actually prevents bone fractures. So there are medicines
but
that...
But what about improves bone density?
It does improve bone density, but it doesn't prevent bone fractures in the large, over 20,000 woman study. And so by themselves, it doesn't do it.
Okay, what is then one of the most important things men and women can do to improve bone density and prevent fractures?
Well, there are two buckets. One is weight-bearing exercise.
Yes.
Do it, do it, do it. And number two is avoid things like alcohol, tobacco, and a sedentary lifestyle that will promote lower bone density. So build and don't break down.
So should men get a test at a certain age, even if they have not had a fracture? And what is that age?
So normally at age 65, we recommend a test, which is a baseline bone density. Yeah. If you have a family history, so your mother, your father had a fracture or osteoporosis, get it earlier. But at 65, see where you fall. Uh-huh. And then at that point, we can decide, well, we just need to follow it, or we need to treat it and reverse it, which we can do.
Yeah. I've had two, and the test doesn't hurt.
Tests don't hurt.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt. No needles. Thank you, Dr. David Akers.